The song is from the Katinas, is it not?
Yeah.
Katinas. They're an awesome Tongan American band, Christian group. And you can hear the beautiful sounds. Okay, everyone. Hey, look, we've decided not to use the microphone because it's a little bit muffled. So if you can come a little bit closer and speak a little bit louder, that'll be cool. But thanks, sis, and that's an awesome song. So awesome for that. And so whoever wants to come up and say something, please feel free. And we're just going to lift up your volume. So are you going to talk up, Michelle? Awesome. I'm recording the sound as well, so please speak from here.
Just lean into the mic.
Yeah, yeah.
Kia ora whānau. Can everyone hear me?
No, we're not using the mic.
Oh, I'm just projecting out. So, I'm the oldest grandchild, so I thought that maybe I should get up and say a few words on about my grandfather and honouring him today on his 80th birthday. Koro, first I want to say how much I love you. And you've been a stalwart in our whānau, you and Nana both, leading the way for us as guiding examples and great examples on how to live a godly and wonderful life. And God has really blessed you with lots of children, lots of grandchildren, just like Abram, because of your faithfulness, both of you, and your dedication, and the love that you have for each other that shows us in our whānau that love conquers all things. So I just want to honour you, Koro, on your 80th birthday, to say that I love you and thank you for everything that you've done, for the fun times, for the giggles over fast cars and not so fast cars. And I just want you to know that I'll always carry a piece of you in my heart. So enjoy your birthday. You deserve it. Kia ora, everybody.
Kia ora, nā tātou e te whānau. Ma tu ake anō au tēnei wā. Pai ke pia kauri au te reo tūrua, ne? Well, I'm standing again. I stood earlier on this afternoon up in the marae at the Paipai and expressed my feelings at that moment. But since I've come down here, I've had more feelings. So I couldn't resist. I had to get up again. And I want to say to you, Willie, this is a great occasion. This is a great occasion for you and Violet to come back here and for your whānau to support you in bringing your birthday back here on this marae. And when I say marae, I don't actually mean the marae itself, but in the papakāinga, in Parihaka. It's the places where we traded as children. And I feel very humble indeed to have been asked to come to this celebration today and to look around and see all the descendants, the relatives of the Graham family. I've heard a lot of koro as a child and growing up in Parihaka about the Arawhana Graham. What a great man he was. Well, I knew Jimmy Graham, I knew Ty, I knew them as a youngster. But the others I didn't know well. With Willie's mum, I only saw on the occasions when she came to visit Jimmy, you could hear me. In the odd times, that's the only time I ever got to see her person. Didn't have to know her like how I knew Hemi and Ty, Tyapo. They were great people. And the stories that I've heard about Willie, I've heard from Albie Martin. Mm-hmm. Albie has spoken well of you, Willie. He's great well. And so, it's just that I really don't know how to express myself at this occasion. I feel so humbled and joyful to have been asked to come along tonight. So with that, I say thank you to the whānau. Thank you to the whānau indeed for having the courage and determination to be here today. With that, I thank you all indeed. And to you, Willie, I wish you a very happy birthday. Now, I don't know if anyone got to 90, you're going to go past that. All right. You're not far behind me, so if you keep pushing me along. So with that, kia ora no tātou. Thank you.
Mr. Rangi Kōtuku, everyone, give him a round of applause. Thank you, Mr. Hey, just one little notice we need to have before people start leaving. If they could sign, there's a beautiful gift book, visitor's book. So what we might do, if people want to, we'll send it over, put it over in the middle here before you leave, before you have to close off, just sign it and just write something. See? everything cool? Okay. I also want to, just while we've got a bit of a break, I just want to unveil another gift that was designed, commissioned, and purposed for you, Dad. And it's a beautiful taonga. So we want to, I want to just acknowledge, first and foremost, Lionel, the master carver here, this gentleman here from, that's him right there. And hey, I'm just going to, thanks for these beautiful gifts here. These are awesome. Now I just, but I do want to just acknowledge this one particular here. And this is a bend my knees chest. And it's got the beautiful, this is my daughter, Te Rapaunami, everyone. And it's a beautiful tōtara chest. And it's very heavy, but it's very beautifully carved by Lionel. And so that's going to be used, be put all Dad's photo albums and some taonga in there, that visitor's book and stuff like that. So that's why it's really important to sign that visitor's book, everyone, please. And, but, so what the significance is here is the te raukura feathers, obviously, for taranaki, and from down here, the maunga, but it also represents the Waikatawa and the waterways, the rivers, for Dad's Tainui side, okay? So that's awesome. Thank you. Cool. So, yeah, floor's still open if anyone wants to stand up and say something. Uncle Leo? Hold on.
Kia ora. I'm like that last speaker. I'm very humbled too, being here and being the first time, and like I said, I hope it's not the last. Yeah, 80. Yeah. Yeah. I'll see if I can pass that. But I've got a long way to go. Like I said earlier, I am the baby of them all, out of 20. I am the baby. And yeah. No, I won't cry, it's all right. Willie, I'd like to wish you the very best on your 80th birthday, man. And I wish you would carry on through the years. And I think you will too, because you've got that man up there behind you, all the way. Kia ora tātou, kia ora.
Kia ora Leo, thank you. Now, I'm also just going to give some apologies as well. There's my brother Victor, and he's farming down in the deep south, right down near Invercargill, and he couldn't make it tonight. Today, they're carving at the moment, so he's farm managing that. So, just on behalf of Victor, he did send an email for Dad, which I'll give to Dad to read later. But he just sends his apologies and just congratulations to Dad on his birthday. Okay, so that's Brother Victor, and yeah. Also, another apology from Auntie Emma, who couldn't make it. She's just unwell at the moment, so all our love and support go to her, and our prayers that she's got the Lord. The Lord is with her, so that's with the Lord before you. Then who or what can be against you? Amen. Okay, so now the floor's back open again. Whoever wants that.
E tangi ana te manua te hui e, hui e, hui e, hui e. E haka hui hui te ai tātou, i runga i tōna reo karau. E tangi ana te manua te tūi, tūi, tui, tuia. e tui tui nei tātou ki a rātou kua wehe atu. E tangi ana te manu a te pītango tango, ki rungi te maunga titohia a Taranaki, e tango ana te mana, te wairua te tangata. Nā, ko tātou tēnā e hui hui nei, e tau nei, ti he mauriora. Tēnā pia ka huri taku reo i te reo Pākehā. Kia mōhia i tātou katoa taku kōreo, taku mihi ki taku Ankara. Oi nōra, Uncle Willie, I just want to let everyone else know, I was one of the ones that used to come on holiday with my nanny, Hera, Nanny Sally. I grew up at Uncle Willie's Reke Reke. I was one of those, and we used to always love going to his place in Eltham, Taylor Street. Hey, Uncle, was it Taylor Street? Yeah, that's the one. Well, the big flash, that big flash house that had all these hiding places. And we had to sing for our supper. Remember that, Uncle? Ki te kore koe he waiata, aroha, ka aroha. If you didn't know a waiata, you had to know a kouhou. You had to do a sermon or do a kōrero. Man, you had to learn quick or you starve. Well, you know, I really loved my uncle and auntie, and my auntie reminded me of those beautiful actresses in the movies. Kei te pērā tonu. A tāhua tonu. Tēnā koe, auntie. Yeah, kōrua tahi. Tēnei ka tūpoto i mua ia koutou. Mua ia te whānau. Tānia, you probably won't remember me. You were the youngest. You were the youngest one at the time. At the time, aye. I only remember as far as you. But then everyone's asking, gee, who's that fella there? So kia kore ai e noho teko teko noiho. I thought I'd better get up and say something. This is a special place for me. This place, e te rangatire, rangi tō kōtuku. Te nape a kāre koe e tino mōhio kowai tēnei ihu hupe nei. We came here one time, we had a wānanga about the kingitanga, he ha te honunga te kingitanga ki kone, ki parihaka. And I came with this group, our whānau, and wanting to know about arawhena. Long time ago, matua. But you're still here. Tēnā hoi, tēnā hoi. Oh, see your handsome face, tēnā hoi. So I've actually grown up a little bit too, and filled my kete up. I went to pursue our reo rangatira. So whānau, I've been in Tauranga Moana for nearly 30 years now. I live over there. I married a princess from Tauranga Moana. All my children are born there. And I just had another new moho. So kāre tu atu ngā moho puna. Anei tētahi whakatau ki Waihuatea e au ki a tātou nei. Ahako no tainui tēnei whakatauki. Ana, tukua te ahi o te kotahitanga. Kia mura, kia okeoke, pāinaina i tōna ahurutanga. Which means, let the flames of unity burn brightly. And let's bask in its warmth. He hui pēneina. He hui tahi ai, ngā tahi ai tātou. Oi nōra, koina taku pahu mo tēnei rā no reira, tēnā koutou, hurinoa, tēnā tātou katoa. Anei te waiata, tēnā pē anku, te pūru taitanga. I don't know what chores you want to do, uncle, but kai awe. Hei
a.
Aua, e awa, rangi rua wākua. Tama e. E puru tai tama hoki, e puru tai tama, e puru tuki tuki, e puru tai tama e. Ka haere. Ka haere ta hua e. Kirei ra taranaki hoki. Ana, ai ko koe tēnā te pūrua, ango. Ko koe tēnā te pūru. Ka eke taumata kē koe ki te waru te kau. Tēnei ka tūpoto i mua i a koutou. Tātou katoa no reira, tēnā koutou. Tēnā koutou, huru noi te whare a tāhua nei. Tēnā tātou katoa. Tēnā.
Thank you, Robert. Kia ora, ladies and gentlemen, I'm just going to ask Pauline to come up, and she has a gift to present on behalf of herself and Stephen Dix. So if you want to say something, Pauline,
yeah, just, well, yeah, actually, go for it. Steve should actually be here because he can speak Maori and I can't, so you'll have to excuse me on that. He's over in Papua New Guinea working, but we did make a trip up on the Harley 3 weeks ago at Tanka Willie's and had a few hours with him and caught up. He's asked me to give this very special thing to Tanka Willie from our families to you and your family, and maybe you could read back on the back of the top.
Okay, should have got more glasses. This is really small font.
Sorry.
The origins of this... tiki. This is a tiki, everyone. This is a tiki.
And, it's hand carved.
And it's hand carved. And it's,
you can read it later.
It's a hei tiki, everyone. So we'll give that to Dad and we'll put it over here for by the, so you can see it by the lovely Cody. Sorry, I wish I could have read that.
It's all right. It's a special, it's a carver that Steve met years ago in Nigeria. And we actually have been looking for that piece and finally got it this morning. And he just said to pass on to you. He's sitting over there working, sweltering heat, hoping that you're enjoying yourself tonight. But yeah, happy birthday, Uncle Willie. It's really lovely to be invited. Thank you.
So as Dad was saying, that's Johnny Dix's son, Stephen Dix. Yeah. Okay, so the floor's still open, everyone, if you will just feel free. Here we go. Nah. Brother T from Australia, my whānau.
Did you say Steve?
Yeah.
Kia ora, everybody. I'm the fourth eldest, I think. I can't quite remember. But anyway, Dad, it's good being here. Me and Lizzie managed to get here, as you know, like we weren't originally going to come, but I managed to get a bit of time off from work, so I just want to say thank you to all my brothers and sisters that live over here for the amount of work and effort they've, and Mum, to going to Dad's birthday, and also Dad, all the, how many grandkids over there? We got eight. Eight grandkids, and the nine great-grandchildren over there. They send your love to you, so, yeah. Yeah, I just needed to get up and say that, so everybody have a good night, and see what happens later, eh?
Right, we'll sing this song. This is T's, T's song. Come on, man.
Come on, Bill, get up here.
Come up here.
Lizzie.
This is his wife, Lizzie.
Come on, Lizzie. Come on.
Okay. This is a Kiwi song, Māori song.
Oh,
yeah, no. Have a friend on me, and all they do is play for me. They come from miles around to hear them play your melody. Beneath the stars, my dear desire to play a song for you. And if you're with the one, this is what you do. Oh, a hula to my dang guitars. Very soon you'll know just where you are. Through the eyes of love you'll see a thousand stars. And when you dance to my dang guitar.
Dance to my see some family over here. That's
I'm Peter.
Oh, I know.
Stole my thunder.
Ah, kia ora, everybody. Oh, that's what I'm saying. First of all, congratulations, Willie. He certainly don't look 90. I'll say 70. Violet, you're still as beautiful as ever. And you're proud, you got a beautiful family. And to your family, I want to let you know that you're lucky. Way back in the late 50s, Willie and Violet adopted me. But the immigration department or whoever it handles declined our, so I wasn't allowed to be adopted into Graham, so I had to stay. I am actually one of the Rūpapara whānau. But I go back as a young fella. Willie and Violet were milking cows at Pihama, and we moved into the, Dad was working in the cheese factory those days. And we moved to Pātiki. Dad was working in Pātiki cheese factory. And I was about, I'm trying to think now, 7 or 8 year old, and Willie and Violet took me under their wings. And I ended up milking cows for them after school and weekends, and I used to love it, thoroughly enjoyed it. I got fond memories of it. And I still remember the horse that I used to ride to get the cows in. Used to stream it, throw me off a few times, but I can't remember the name of the horse, Willie. little horse you had?
Champion.
Oh, yeah. Anyway, Hemi and Karen, I'm sort of, I can go back, I was about 8 year old, and 7, 8 year old. Karen was the baby, little toe rag she was then, still loose. Hemi was the baby, I think. And then, who came after him? You can't remember now. But anyway, as time went by, Mum and Dad, we moved to Rivoli. And as years went by, from there, moved to Eltham. And we all met up again. The Grahams moved to Eltham, and we were... then there was another generation of kids there, Willie. Yeah. The Tecton generation. I come from a family of 16. So, I left my family at a young age because I had to get married, unfortunately, and these things happen. And looking around, Tania and Atta and the boys. David, I can't remember, David, he was their baby, I think, Elson. The ones that are born in Elson, they all went to school with my younger brothers and sisters. So, we're not related, but as a whānau, we call ourselves we've had very close connections with Willie and Violet and his family. So I'm proud to be here and my family over here. proud to be here today. And fortunately, one sister went down with the flu today, so she left her home. And one from Wellington couldn't make it. And a young brother couldn't make it, unfortunately. But I'll keep short and sweet because I know my brother's going to say a few words. So thank you very much, everyone. And thanks to all the cooks at the back for a beautiful kai. Absolutely awesome. Here's my brother Ben. Chris over here. The old saying, you know, Willie. Behind every good man is a good lady. And I can't have kind of do that in.
Awesome.
I just want to say something before we go to our way after. A few weeks ago I got this email. There's this lovely photo on this email wishing to be my friend. Anyway, I was just telling my sister-in-law's over here. And the name didn't ring a bell at the time, you see. And bugger me days, it was Karen. And I just straight away, delete, you know. And Karen, I apologise. Dear, you flick that email back to me and I'll accept it. You're my friend on Facebook, mate. But I myself, Willie, happy birthday, mate. Thank you. And on behalf of my whānau, and hope you have a very enjoyable evening. Thank you very much.
Oh, just to further what Karen, she sent me a. This is true. Roo is spelled R-U, but she spelled it R-O-O. R-O-O. Where the hell did you get that from, Gil?
Kangaroo, isn't it, mate? Kangaroo. Obvious.
And also, in my younger days, Willie and Barney just used to put clothes on my back. I can remember that. Thank you, Willie.
I was going to sing an old Waiata hymn called Green Green Grass of Hope. The old hometown looks the same as I step down from the train, and there to meet me was my mama and my father. Down the road I look, and there I carry hair of gold and lips like cherry. It's good to touch the green, green grass.
Thank you, Woody.
Thank you.
Thank you to the brothers.
Thank you, Woody.
I was actually at school with another younger brother, Dallas. So, Dallas Root. And so thank you. Floor's still open. Actually, I just want to acknowledge my brother Hemi, the Aotearoa. I've sort of been speaking without acknowledging him, so I do acknowledge my brother Hemi. And what am I, Mata?
Ngā mihi o tahuri tau ki a koe I te matua e Willie. Happy birthday to you, Violet. Thank you, Karen, wherever you are. Thank you for the invitation. It's really honour and a pleasure to be here tonight. I wanted to come straight up after Boydie. He was talking about the farm. Well, him and I both worked on the farm. And I'm glad Boydie left this piece out. He mentioned a horse.
He did too.
And that horse, him and I used to fight over. And the poor horse's head going this way, going that way, going this way, and then it would back and pull the both of us. Because I guess it was undecided what it was going to do, so it made up its own mind what it wanted to do. So Boydie and I both were working on Woolley's farm. I loved working there because I got to drive the tractor. A Massey Ferguson 45. And you know, when they talk about modern cars got these kind of electronic starts now, you know? Beautiful, just jump in and you just look at a button or even flick your finger or whatever. All of a sudden, away she goes. Well, you know, I want to tell you something, that's out of date. The old Massey Ferguson, all you had to do was shove it into gear and away she'd go. She'd start. She would start. That was the automatic press. So they had them way back there on the farm during the farming days. And so I wanted to jump up after Boydie straight away because him and I both worked with Willie on the farm together and we enjoyed it. And I even stayed at their home in Pātiki Road. I used to stay there and sleep there with them and get up in the morning and go over and milk the cows. And I tell you what, if you're a husband of if you're a farmer here and your wife, part of the farm too is what I'm trying to say, I tell you what, you got a good cook. Farmers' wives are very good cooks. And Violet was like that on the farm. Beautiful. I remember all the wonderful meals we used to have at the house. And, you know, I went shearing one time after that. And even shearers, farmers, wives, wow, you can smell the cooking coming up the footpath, that sort of thing. Yeah, it was a real, for me, it was a real pleasure to be there and to be able to work. Now, the other part too, and before I get into the other part, I think I must remember, I got two foster brothers here too as well, Lewis and Lyman. We were all brought up together under the name of Wharemate. And can I add here too, Uncle Willie's brother, the late Bob Williams, was brought up by my dad. And we all lived, they lived over in Hastings in the end. But Bob had a son, and his son is here too with us today, Lyman, sitting here today, and was adopted by my dad. And so this is our connection with the whānau, Graham. And the other part I was going to talk about was the Christianity. That started way back in Pihama for Willie and Violet. And of course also my oldest brother too, I thought would be here today, but unfortunately I guess he couldn't make it. So I give his apologies. But Christianity started all around Pihama Pātiki. And it's kind of like we move from one level of Christianity, and what I'm saying is we move from the mainline churches, the Catholic, the Anglicans, the Presbyterians, St. John's, and we kind of moved up to another level in which they call the Holy Spirit area. And that's the area that we all came under. And now today, I'm pleased to hear Lionel speaking today about your enjoyment within the Christianity side of what Matua Wuli was showing you and everything that you shared with us. And so Wuli's been in the faith for a very, very, very long time, him and Violet. And now I'm hearing the children too as well. And that's what it's all about. The Bible says, Jesus said, I am the same yesterday, today, and forever. I am the Lord, I change not. And Violet, they were complimenting you on you. You look like you're only young and beautiful. And so I guess you passed those comments. And somebody was talking about age, Willie. Well, I'm kind of thinking about our prophet Noah. He lived to 120. So there you go. Might be a chance for us all yet. By the grace of God, we'll be able to move in to that age of Noah, perhaps. Yeah, perhaps. Our thoughts are not his thoughts, neither are his ways our ways, or our ways his ways. And so with that, I just wanted to share this as my whānau connection from the Wharemate side, and also having a half-brother, the brother of Wooly, being part of our whānau too, as well. And so with that, whānau, thank you very much. Ngā mihi o te rungarawa ki a koutou, ki a tau mai te rangi Māria ki rungi a koe, e te matua e Wuli, i roto tēnī e te wā e taia ki tō huritau. Nō reira tēnī te mihi ki a koe, tēnā koe, tēnā koe. Mui tō tamariki whānau hoki, e ngā mokopuna katoa, a rātou mā, a tēnī te mihi ki a rātou, ki a koutou. Huri no, huri no tēnī e tō tātou are piringa, a tēnī te mihi, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou. Kia ora mai tātou katoa. E aha e wai. This man and I, we get around, this kaumātua and I, we get around together around here in Taranaki. So. I'm trying to, yeah, okay, yeah, Mark. Yep, go by. Everybody, Staying at the house. I think you've expanded since then. Engari, tēnei te mihi ki a koutou katoa, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou. Kia ora mai tātou. Oh.
Kia ora family and friends. I'm Lyman. I'm the one he was talking about, or being part of the family. Just an acknowledgement from my side, from the Williams side, speaking to Mum and the rest of the family. They apologise, and they would like me to pass that message on. And just getting down to what's actually happening, I'd like to acknowledge the main table, and of course, the birthday boy. I've always been pleasantly surprised with my uncle and auntie. I was brought up around them, and I couldn't understand how they had such a big family and were able to cope with, you know, day-to-day living. It still surprises me because I look at the family and the family's just branched out, expanded too, you know, incredible, incredible. But I'd like to acknowledge also my cousins, Karen, the boys, everyone, for inviting us and giving us the opportunity to be here. I'd like to thank my brother, my older brother, for acknowledging me, and Lewis and the rest of our family as well. Appreciate it. But it's all I wanted to say. Thank you. Have a good night. If it brings you happiness,
I'm My name's Peter, Peter Joe. I'm from the Rangitoto Williams side, this lot here. Most of us are part Chinese. Anyway, Uncle, I acknowledge you. Happy birthday. Andy got it. First of all, I'd like to say on behalf of Andy Jean, happy birthday to you, boy. And, oh, is it? Oh, happy birthday. And, you know, because of her age, she can't travel. But, I'm sure your thoughts of you in her mind. Okay. What am I going to say? Oh, yeah, well, I said happy birthday. Yeah, we're from the Rangitoto side of the family. Thank you, Karen, and all the family. It's a beautiful spread. We're happy to be here. Hey?
We've got the singers.
Oh, we've got to sing. Do we?
No, we're Chinese.
We're Chinese. We
my name's Carnation. I am the oldest daughter of Uncle Willie's youngest sister. And these are my Hanumana half-breed cousins, belonging to Auntie Alice, Auntie Maggie, Auntie King's daughter over there, and Auntie Dolly's daughter and son. So, I'm going to get up and sing. Oh, happy birthday, Uncle, from all of us from the Manawatu, comes from Narawahia. Yeah, no. So we'll get the photo up. We're going to sing something. I don't know what, but we'll start. Charles, you want to say something? Or Sunny? Yep.
Have your say, and then we'll sing the song at the end.
Yep. You have a say. Thank
you. Kia ora, Sunny. Kia ora tātou katoa. Tuatai nā mihia tinei ki tō tātinei matunui te rangi. I whakataungi mai tana Wairua kei rungi a mātou ana tamariki ngā wā katoa, i ngā wahi katoa. A tuarua, kei te mihi ki o koutou ngā kaumātou o tēnei whare o Parihaka. A ta moe o tātou nei te tino kaha o tēnei wāhi o Parihaka. I ngā rau i moe a tātou nei rauri o tēnei wāhi kātū i rungi te kaha. No reira, kei te mihi ki a korua ngā kaumātou. Anyway, tēnei rā hoki e Uncle Willie, tēnei anō te mihi whakanui ki a koe i rungi tō rā i tēnei rā, te rā whakanui mō tō waru tikau, tēnei te mihi ki a koe. Tātou katoa te whānau i tau mai nei, i raru te maro, tēnei whare, i rungi tēnei rā whakahirahira, o reira tēnā tātou katoa. Kāpai. Ka hurei te reo tuarua pēnei. O Sunny Pautapu hau, ko au te tamo o Violet. Taku whaia Violet, ko ia te te o ngā tuahine o Uncle Willie. Reira, tēnā tātou katoa. I just really want to just give thanks to our God also for Uncle Willie and Auntie Violet. When I say Uncle Willie, I really mean both, because that's what I'm used to seeing all my life. When I was a child and we grew up and we saw Uncle Willie and Auntie Violet, they were always together. It was kind of something that we probably missed in our own marriage, in our own lives. But just seeing them, the things I remember about Uncle Willie and Auntie Violet, ka tū rātou nei te tino kaha te kaue nei te rongo pai, me te rangi Māori o tō tātou nei matu nei te rangi. I kia nā kōrero e tahi o ngā e te roha, ko koutou mā nā ka tū. So those are the things that I remember. That Uncle Willie and them, they were always about the Lord's work. And so, whether they knew it or not, you know, the rest of our whānau katoa, we all knew that. And when it was one thing we knew that our mother reminded us of was Uncle Willie and Auntie Violet, they were about doing the Lord's work, always preaching And I still have early memories, Uncle, of you preaching. I must have been very young. It might have been one of the times I came to Eltham, and I probably went to town with you, I think, and I've seen some people preaching on the back of a truck or something. But that, the very early memories of those days. So I just want to give thanks to you, Uncle and Auntie. Really, you know, they've been like the pautaku mana for our whānau katoa. And they've always been the ones that have stood there and stood strong. I roti te karaititanga. O reira kei te mihi kia kōrua nei a haere anō, whakahaere tērā mahi ngā wā katoa ngā wahi katoa. O reira, tēnei wā hoki nā kei te mihi ki tō tātenei ki ngā tūheitia. E tau toko ngā kōrero o rātou mā e kā tūni te kōrero i mui a tātou i tēne, i te poro, i te wānanga i muara. No reira, kei te mihi ki a tātou. Now, we're going to sing a song. We've got to get a song.
We're going to try.
Yep, well, I'll try. Tēnei te ā wanga wanga nēnei a kō. Ko wari wari ngā kupu te waiata anōna. Come on, we gotta get a song here.
I don't know.
You know that one?
Ask Auntie Sadie to come up because she's just about to has to go back to sleep.
Kia ora whānau. I would at this stage, Willie, wish you happy birthday for the rest of the evening. I'm here. I actually went to school with Willie. So, and he was a very shy sort of a person going to school when I, you were, Willie, you were shy and very well-behaved person at school. He got on well with my brother and they were great friends at school, so we have something in common here. So, and you've never changed, Willie. You're still a quiet sort of a person and a very loving person you are, and you're doing the right job for our people. That's how I see you today. But in saying that, I was talking to Violet earlier, and I mentioned about her family, and she's telling me about her family, and it's quite strange because when I left college, I started nursing at the Opanaki home, at the cottage home. And she said she had some of her children there, but I can't remember any of the children there, Violet, but it's nice to think that I did nurse there for a while. But I also want to thank Karen. Karen. Was Karen there? Karen. Thank you. Thank you for this marvellous... You made it look like a palace. And I must remember how you've got the tables arranged because I might need it in the near future. And Mairangi said, don't forget to remember how it's all laid out. And I said, oh, I promised her, but Mairangi, you need to help me here. So this is Mairangi down there. But you've done a wonderful job for Dad's birthday. When I walked in that back door, I couldn't believe my eyes. I normally do this room up myself. And this is just another new idea. So thank you for coming along here and giving us this pleasure. And for Mum and Dad, I'm sure they got a fright when they saw it. But I think it gave everybody a fright, because normally it doesn't look like this. But thank you for that, Karen, and the wonderful meal. Vi, thank you for this wonderful meal here again. I'm used to setting tables up, but I don't think I can beat this one tonight. I need to thank you, Karen. Thank you for all your work. And God bless your family. And Willie, bless you. Thank you.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy with stars of rain. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine.
Okay, that's a good idea, Dad. Dad wants us to just quickly, before we get on to the next speech, we're just going to charge a glass to our kaumātua before they have to leave. So if you've got a glass there, you can put a juice in it or water or anything there.
Tēnā koutou, e kui mai, koroma. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Ko Mark Mitchell, taku ingoa, no Whanganui a hau. Ko Queenie, Tamihana, taku Waini, no Ngāti Kārewa. Ngāti Tāinga, me Ngāti Kārewa, Tainui. Ko Ihu Karaiti, tōku Hepara. Nā tō o Hiona, tōku Iwi, tōku Hapu. Privileged to be here at your birthday, Koro. And I don't know much about Parihaka, but I know that you know, the people from here will know that the genealogy goes back a long way. But what I do know is that we had an awesome kai here. And there was heaps left over. And it wasn't just because of all our wonderful ringawera and the preparation and stuff that's gone on, but because there's a kōrero up here on the wall. And the genealogy of that goes back further, as I understand. You have 12 kite up there. And there's a whole lot of people. You can't see how many. But I can tell you in that story there that there was at least 5,000 men besides women and children. So there could have been at least 25,000, right, if they only had 2 kids each. And what's happening there is that in the kete you had bread and fish. And the story comes from the Bible. And it was Jesus had all these people thronging them around him. And his disciples were freaking out and saying, Lord, how are we going to feed all these people? And he said, don't worry about it, feed them. He said, but we haven't got enough kai. Should we go down the shop? He said, no. And a small boy come up and he offered up his lunch. Couple of bread and a couple of fish. He says, oh, here, Lord, you can use this. And the Lord took the bread and he broke it. And he offered it up to the Father. And it fed all those people. And afterwards, the disciples walked around and they picked up 12 basketfuls of leftovers. And there's not only one account of that in the Bible. That might be the other account, because there's more than 2 fish in that kete up there. That might be where he fed the 4,000 plus. But there was a couple of accounts in the Gospels of that. And what it is that unless something is broken, it can't be blessed. Just something to think about, you know. When we come to that place of brokenness, that's when the Lord can step in and do the work in our lives to rebuild us. Hai kura. I sort of have to get up here and have a kōrero because being the prayers of our club, nationwide, has been going 21 years, Christian Motorcycle Club. It's quite a hard road out there, and amongst our brothers that fly all the other colours and that. And Koro Wiramu there, he's right behind us. He tautokos us, and we've got now an annual East Coast run on the last weekend of February. We go right around the East Coast, and it's growing each year. And Koro comes and rides shotgun in the backup wagon, and he's kaumātua, you know, and he does the stuff for us on the marae, and you know where we go, and here's a ball, he loves it, eh? Awesome. But you know, being the age that he is, the last 2 years he come, he would have been 79 and 78, and he went to sleep, and it's a biker clubhouse, and they got a bar, and us Christian fellas aren't drinking, but all these other fellas are getting on it. And must have been about, Koro was fast asleep. And it must have been about, midnight at least. And this fellow from up there, Willie, jumps on his bike and decides to do a burnout right inside the clubhouse, right beside where this fella's sleeping. Hey! Smoke going everywhere. He jumped up, he didn't know what. He thought the Lord had returned. good fun, and with that we got a taonga for you in your support of us. And these here we don't give out lightly. So that's put into your whakahuia over there. So it's Tautoko Warriors is on. One more thing is that I know that Koro loves the Word of God, and I knew I was coming here, and so this morning when I was having the coffee, I says, well, Lord, what's the Word? And he gave me three verses from Isaiah 59, and, you take it how you like. He put on righteousness as his breastplate and the helmet of salvation on his head. He put on the garments of vengeance and wrapped himself in zeal as in a cloak. From the west, men will fear the name of the Lord, and from the rising of the sun, they will revere his glory. As for me, this is my covenant with them, says the Lord. My spirit who is in you, Wiremu, Graham, and my words that I have put in your mouth will not depart from your mouth or from the mouths of your children or from the mouths of their descendants from this time on and forever, says the Lord. Ka uri. I'm not a singer, so.
Why are the brothers?
That this mural was painted by the queer just leaving now, and it was painted because of in times of old that food was very scarce or hard to get to feed the people, but once that was painted, the Lord has provided ever since because of the representation and the acknowledgement of the Lord. So praise God. Thank you very much.
Kia ora whānau. Hari huri te uncle. Oh, to all. I think my daddy's getting tired down there. However, my name's Ngāwai. I'm here on behalf of my mum, Takurangi, whose mum, Hera, then Hera's mum, Tahuri Rukuwai, is big sister to Uncle Willie's mother, Nanny Toto. I've got some of my sisters here. My daddy, love you daddy, we're here for mummy too, for uncle. Uncle. This here, daddy showed it to me this morning as we're coming here. This is your mother's. You want it? Oh, no. No. But we'll take mummy out to uncle's birthday. I knew I didn't want it because I didn't want to be up here making a speech of any kind. But I really want to say a big thank you to all my cousins, especially Karen, for once again getting in touch with myself. Cousin, I haven't even come and uffied you, but I will. Love you, cuz. And meeting all these other cousins of mine, which I knew some of the names, but man, it's just beautiful. And we too have a... funny that, Uncle, I just was talking to... I didn't realise you got 12 in your family like we have, like Mum and Dad have. And then I thought, no wonder all the ages are all like all our ages, my cousins and that. And so some of us aren't here due to mahi, but we have a gift here.